Well, I mean, it'll go back to when I was a kid. I mean, I was a really sick kid. I developed epilepsy when I was 8 years old, and I'd have violent seizures, and I would literally I couldn't get out of bed. I couldn't walk. Sometimes I couldn't walk for a week or two. And my mom went to the library. I mean, we were lower middle income. My dad was in the Navy. He was in Vietnam. My mom's trying to sell real estate on the side. We didn't have a lot of money.
In raw, candid interviews, Rick Harrison has finally opened up about the true story behind his journey from a struggling child to a business mogul. The truth begins with a pivotal moment that changed everything.
My mom went and got me a set of books that was sort of kismet. This really like changed my life. She went to the library, and it was John D. Fitzgerald's The Great Brain. It was about an eight-year-old kid growing up in Utah in the 1890s, coming up with all these little schemes to make money. And I just devoured the books.
This early exposure to entrepreneurship would shape Harrison's entire approach to business. His passion for reading and learning would become a defining characteristic of his success.
And I just fell in love with reading ever since then. I mean, I was 12 years old. I was going to the library and checking out books on physics. One of the jokes I tell is I read the history of batteries twice. I found it so fascinating. And to this day, I still read things like that. And it's once you develop a really diverse, you know, knowledge in your head, you can, when you see something, you can start figuring things out, I guess.
His path wasn't straightforward. He had to overcome significant educational barriers, but his determination never wavered.
You never went to college, did you?
Nope.
All this talk about free college, and you can't make it unless you went to college. How far in high school did you go?
Finished the ninth grade.
Ninth grade?
Yeah.
Then what happened?
I did a little bit of job here. I started buying and selling stuff. Basically educated myself.
Despite his lack of formal education, Harrison was determined to succeed. He learned from his father's example of hard work and perseverance.
Now, your father just passed away.
Yeah. My father was an amazing guy. 20 years in the Navy, great father. You know, I had epilepsy when I was a kid. He did not treat me one bit different because of it. When I was 12 years old, it was 5:30 in the morning, Saturday morning, get out of bed, grab your nail backs. Because my dad would not buy apartments unless there was a condemned sticker on every door. Because he'd get them so much cheaper, and we rehab.
His commitment to knowledge and authenticity would become the cornerstone of his business strategy, setting him apart from competitors.
No, I used to have to go to this library every Saturday and like research stuff, because remember back then there wasn't an internet.
Right. She actually, wow. So you'd sit in a library, and that's how you'd learn about
I'd
things.
Learn all kinds of stuff. I remember once I bought I knew there were photo graves. It's an expensive photo process way back in the day of American Indians. And so I bought some, you know, I bought some of my, for like $50 a piece, because I had no idea what they were. The lady didn't have, you know, and then it turns out there were Edward Curtis photo graves, and they were, all the negatives were in the Smithsonian. I did really, really well in that.
This dedication to research and learning paid off when he opened his own pawn shop, where he developed a unique business model.
There was a couple independent pawn shops in town, but most of them all owned by really large chains. Most people don't realize this. There's one chain of pawn shops in the United States with 1,000 stores, and there's another one with 1,000 stores. I mean, so I realized quickly you can't go head-to-head with Walmart. I had to be Tiffany's. I mean, like in the early 90s, there's always got to be a Picasso on the wall. There's this place has to be immaculately clean. Just the best employees, everything better than everybody else.
His unique approach to business led to some fascinating encounters, including some that tested his integrity.
Hey, this is a weird story. So yeah. A guy came in the pawn shop with 7 human skulls and a double bag. I am not kidding, okay? And it was like, whoa. I mean, no, but he showed me all the... There was a dental school in the Midwest, yeah. Okay? And they were selling out like a warehouse full of just old stuff. And I guess they used to teach with real skulls and everything like that. And I'm looking at this guy like, you know, on the show when I say, let's do some paperwork. Well, that paperwork is I'm buying stuff off you and turning it into the FBI. Right, a little police report to the FBI.
His success in the pawn business led to unexpected opportunities, including television stardom. But even this didn't happen by accident.
No, it aired in July of 2009.
Uh-huh.
And, I could see business definitely picking up and everything. But I took a couple weeks off during Christmas, come back, show up in the morning at work. I got the fire department there because there's, a couple hundred people trying to get to the pawn shop, and it just blew up.
Yeah.
It went insane, and been that way ever since. Yeah.
Today, Harrison has expanded beyond his original pawn shop, embracing new challenges and opportunities.
But anyway, it's been a passion of mine for years. I've basically had to rebuild just about everything here, but it's an amazing piece of property. I had to go off grid here. It's miles and miles from any power lines here. I'm off the grid, but I also want to be comfortable. So I don't want a loud screaming generator running all day long. I like to hear the creak. So we've rebuilt the old hydro plant. We've also put in some solar. I have two different power systems here. I have one for my machine shop, and then I have a hydroelectric power plant that makes right at 2 kilowatts. And that system right there powers 3 houses.
Despite his success, Harrison remains committed to giving back and helping others overcome similar challenges to those he faced.
Just continue to enjoy life. Life is amazing. It's short. Take the advantage of it. 3 weeks ago, I was 25 years old. It seems that way sometimes. Right. No, and I just want to have a great life. I still do tons of stuff for, Las Vegas. I'm on the National Board of Directors of the Epilepsy Foundation. I do a bunch of work with them. I do a bunch of different charity work. It's going to buy me a better place in hell.
And, your work with Epilepsy Foundation is really important. Is there a website address that you can give
it's
everybody?
It's epilepsy.com. And every year I have one of the biggest motorcycle runs in Nevada. And we raise money for the Epilepsy Foundation. And the money I raise in Nevada stays in Nevada.
The rumors about Rick Harrison have always circulated. But through these raw interviews, he finally confirms the truth. His success wasn't built on luck or shortcuts, but on an unwavering commitment to learning, authenticity, and constant reinvention. From a sick kid who couldn't leave his bed to a television star and philanthropist, his story stands as testimony to what's possible when determination meets opportunity, even in the face of significant obstacles. His journey from reading library books during epileptic episodes to running a multi-million dollar empire proves that success isn't about where you start. It's about your willingness to learn, adapt, and persevere. Harrison's story isn't just about building a pawn shop or becoming a TV star. It's about the American dream in its purest form. The idea that with enough dedication, knowledge, and hard work, anyone can transform their circumstances and create something extraordinary. In the end, the biggest revelation isn't about the rare artifacts or celebrity encounters. It's about a man who turned his greatest challenges into the foundation of his success.